SwiftUI is amazing, but there is still a view missing from it. I've been searching for this for a long time, and unfortunately, Apple didn't add it since. So today, I'm going to show you how to build out this layout with the help of Flow View. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and if you want to learn how to build these beautiful layouts, make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, and let's dive in. Let me just show you what we are going to build out today. It is called the Flow View, and this will be our end project. As you can see, we have these kind of tags or cells, whatever you want to call them, and their width is not exactly the same. And we want to make sure that it flows to the next row. So also, we are having a vertical spacing and a horizontal spacing option right over here. So also an alignment. Basically, we want to have a view that it's flowing its element to the next row. This is what we are going to build out today with the help of Flow View. Now, Flow View is available at store.rebeloper.com/flow-view. Go ahead and check it out. And yeah, today we are going to build out such a view. Most probably you are familiar with these kind of tags views. This is what it looks like on the back end of the studio of YouTube of one of my previous videos, StoreKit Pro. And yeah, basically this is what it does. It works on iOS, macOS, and tvOS, and watchOS. And it does make the container automatically wrap to the next row when there's no more space available for that cell. And as you can see, it's working on all of the devices, and there are only two steps for this to set up. The first step is to just import Flow View, just add it into your project, and the next one we are talking about today in the video. And there are some features: vertical, horizontal spacing, alignment. It's 100% documented. There's an Xcode project that you can take a look at with macOS, watchOS, tvOS, iOS targets. And of course, here is the contents for that. Again, it's at store.rebeloper.com/flow-view. Now let's take a look at the demo project. Basically, what this is, it has some demo stuff in it that is kind of helper files right over here. We have a content view model, settings view, where we have those toggles and all of that. And then we have our profile cell view, which has a profile in it. And this lorem ipsum is just helpers for adding in random images and random text. Now let's take a look at, first of all, our content view model, because this is where it's kind of all links in with the data. Basically, we have a profiles array. And as you can see, we are also taking a look at tvOS, watchOS. On those two, we are having a much smaller list of profile by default. Also, we have a published variable for spacing vertically and horizontally, and an alignment. Now, you don't need to do this if you just want to have a set amount of profiles, for example, data, and you do know that the spacing vertically, horizontally are set, and of course the alignment is set for you. This is just for the demo part. And of course we have all of our functions that makes this demo work. And that's it. So the important part to keep in mind is that we have an array of profiles. Now the profiles are, let me just take a look at it, are identifiable and hashable. Now the most important part here is that they do need to be hashable in order for Flow View to lay them out perfectly. And we have an image name and the name, and that's kind of not important in this case. Now, finally, we have what we want to take a look at is the setting view. We have options to set up our Flow View. Just go ahead and take a look at it. It's really straightforward. And of course, the profile cell view. Now, let's go into the content view. In the demo app file, we just have the content view. So that's why we jump right into the content view. We have our content view model initialized. And then we have a little bit of if and else for the different device types. But basically what you want to know is that we have our settings view, either be it in the scroll view or as an overlay, and we want to add in our flow view. And let's do that. So we just go flow view, open parentheses. There are two initializers, one with the data and the content. Now the content is the cell, and one with the vertical spacing, horizontal spacing, alignment, and content. You may choose this second one, but because this is a tutorial on flow view, I'm just going to use this first one so we can just take a look at it, how it looks like. So the data, it comes from the content view model. So we just go content view model dot profiles. So that's our array of hashables. Now for the spacing, we could just go on and add default spacing, maybe just 34 and horizontal spacing 50. I'm just going to go wild here for now, but we are going to hook it up with the content view mobile in just a second. And let's just go for leading for the alignment. Of course, if you omit these, the default values will be used, which is nil for horizontal and vertical spacing and center for the alignment. Okay, so for the content, we are going to get back here a profile, and we have profile in, really nice. And we are going to use our already created profile cell view, which requires us a profile, really handy. So yeah, most probably you already have your cell at hand. So let's just build and run and see how this looks like currently. Again, we have our profiles array, vertical and horizontal spacing set to default values. Of course, also the alignment set to leading. And that's it. As you can see, we have this nice, nice view. But of course, we want to take advantage of these settings whenever we want to. So let's just go ahead and use those published variables from the content view model. So this would be our content view model dot V spacing, our content view model dot H spacing, and the alignment. So the alignment would be our content view model dot alignment alignments at the content view model alignment index. So yeah, basically this is how the setting view works. You will be able to take a look at it later. By the way, you don't have to do this in your own projects. You just set the vertical, horizontal, and alignment as we did previously. But I want to show off how easy it is to just move these around. So let's build and run again. And now comes really the magic part. Let me just make this a little bit larger so we can see this. So if we add a new person right over here, as you can see, it is appended. If we move any of those persons, they will be removed. Yeah, simple, just appending to the array and removing the last element from that array. Now let's take a look at the vertical spacing. As you can see, as I'm moving it all the way up, it has those vertical spaces added, and of course the horizontal spacing. And now you can see that it's automatically organizing itself to the width of the row, which is really, really nice. Let's just maybe have it like this. And then let's select an alignment. It's really nice. As you can see, it's just moving it all the way to the trailing, for example, in our case. And let's add a new profile right over here. It's really great. And I also added a shuffle button right over here, where you will be able to just shuffle all of these. Let's just make it center and have a little bit smaller spacings between those. So let's just shuffle them all around. It's really, really great. Now, this can be found at store.rebeloper.com/flow-view. Now, if you did like this video, I'm most certain that you will love to learn more about APIs for beginners. Go ahead and check out that video right over here. I will see you in there.